And the answer is that up here, there's 8 different possibilities, and down here, there's 16 possibilities. Now, there's 2 ways to go about this. One is to just do the counting, which can get very tedious, at least in the graph down here. Or the other one is to figure out a general rule, which could be quite helpful. And that rule is that any time that you want to move forward, you have 2 different choices that you can make. So once you start in A, there's 2 different choices. You can go either that way or that way. If you're, say, in this vertex here, you have 2 choices. You can either stay up here or you can go down here. Likewise, when you're down here, you can go either this way or that way. So each time you move forward, you can make 1 of 2 choices. And since here, you can make 1 of 2 choices, except for the last time. In the last move, you always have to end up at B. So here we have 1, 2, 3 times that we can make 2 choices. And then we cannot make a choice here anymore. And 2 to the power of 3 is 8. And down here, it's basically the same thing. We just have 1 more of these layers here where we can make a choice. And so that's going to be 2 to the power of 4 or 16.